In the previous tutorial, we have created a scraper to extract data from pexels.com. The next step is to store the scraped data into the database. We will use MySQL. Here I have an empty database, so let's create a table where we are going to store our image objects. New table, name images, columns. ID, it will be an ID from pexels.com. So it will be unsigned integer and a primary key. Then a title as a string. A list of tags as JSON. Resolution and source as strings. Done. Here is the table. Then we need to pull a package. Friends of React PHP MySQL. It is an async MySQL client for React PHP. Go to installation. 0.5, you see it is still unstable. Keep this in mind when using this library. Copy this line and run Composer. The library is installed and we start. Previously we have stopped here. Method scrape returns a promise that resolves with an array of image objects. Now we want to store these objects into the database. Let's review the library. Quick start example. We need to create a factory, then ask this factory for a connection and make a query. OK. Create a factory. Then create a lazy connection. Provide a connection string that consists of username root, has no password, localhost and database called scraping. The main idea of lazy connection is that internally it lazily creates the underlying database connection only on demand, once the first request is invoked, and it will queue all outstanding requests until the underlying connection is ready. Now here, when the promise resolves, instead of printing results, we can try to store them. Use the connection. So we need a request. Insert into images ID, title, tags, resolution and the source. And placeholders for their values. Then for each image we collect params and perform a request. Create an array from image object. ID, title, tags, resolution and the source. Then we call connection query and provide a SQL string with an array of params. Method query returns a promise that resolves with an instance of query result. Let's just print it. Import class name and call var_dump function. And if the request fails, the promise rejects with an exception. We also print it. And by the way, this array can be moved to image object. Go to the bottom. Create method to array and place it here. Just fix the variable name. Replace image with this. And here, instead of array, call image to array. Looks better. Let's check that it works. Run the script. Ah, it fails. Column doesn't match value count. Let's see. The query looks fine. I know. For text we have a JSON column, so we need to encode this value. Run again, and we have two printed query result objects. Then open the table, and here is our scraped data. A few words about queries. It looks like you are performing raw requests and everything you pass here will be placed right into the query. So it looks like there is a room for a SQL injection. Don't worry, when we execute a query, all provided params are escaped. Here it is, file query, method resolve value for SQL. For example, when we have a string, it will be escaped with these characters. So feel free to provide any values and don't be afraid of SQL injection. And we continue with the query. Let's try to insert the same data and see what happens. We have an exception with a duplicate entry for a primary key. Okay, now we know how to perform queries, so let's continue with the scraper. I don't want to leave this raw queries here. So let's extract a storage and move this database related logic there. Create a new class. In constructor we accept a loop and a connection string. Create a lazy connection and store it as a private property. Create method save. It accepts an array of image objects and saves them. Open the main script and remove query logic from here. Copy and paste. Fix connection property and input class names. Done. Move back to the main script. Here, instead of using connection and raw queries, create a storage object. Then use this object to save scraped images. The constructor accepts a loop and a connection string. Inside the callback, replace everything with a single call storage save. Let's run it, but first clear the table. Yes, we see two records here, but the script is still running. Why? Our lazy connection is still opened. Once all images are stored, we should close it. Okay, open storage class and let's create method quit. Why quit? Lazy connection has two methods. Close and quit. The difference is the following. Method close forces the connection to cancel all pending requests, while quit waits until all pending requests will be executed. In our case, we need to quit the connection. And once all images are stored, we quit. Let's try. Again, clear the table and run. You see that the script immediately finishes. That means that the connection was closed and the data has been stored. Let's see what happens if we close the connection instead of quitting. We got errors. This happens because the script runs asynchronously. Here we query the database, but we don't wait for the result. The script continues. And when we call close, the queries are still being executed. Method close interrupts them and we got errors. So change it back to quit. If we run the script one more time, we got errors for duplicate primary keys. To fix it, we can check that there is a record with such ID and if it exists, we skip it. Create new private method exists. Or maybe is not stored. It will return a promise and check if the record with a specified ID doesn't exist in the table. The promise resolves if the record is new and rejects if it is already stored. So, a simple query, select by ID. Then we have query result object. If result rows is greater than 0, we return a rejected promise, otherwise a fulfilled one. Or we can use helper functions reject and resolve. Replace fulfilled promise and rejected promise. If the request fails, we receive an exception and print its message. Then let's make method save private and accept one image object instead of array. Remove the loop and create a new public method with an explicit name saveIfNotExist. It will accept an array of images, loop through them, and check. If this image is not stored in the database, then we use this image and save it. Done. Open the main script and fix method name. Now clear the table, run the script, and I think it's gonna fail. Yes, it fails. Why? Remember that we have quit call here, which gracefully closes the connection. But in our case, we execute select queries, and then the storage quits. So when we try to perform insert queries, the connection is already closed. How we can fix it? First of all, let's remove this quit call and check if everything works. Yes, images were stored, but the script is still running, and it will continue running for 60 seconds. Why 60 seconds? Take a look. Here in the storage, we create a lazy connection. By default, lazy connection will be idle for 60 seconds, and then it will be closed. The next request, after an idle connection has been ended, will automatically create a new underlying connection. This ensures you always get a fresh connection. Well, we don't want an idle connection. Once we are done with queries, we close it. In this case, we can specify zero value here in the connection string. Pass idle equals zero. Now let's run the script again. Clear the table, run, and it quits once we are done with queries. So we can remove this quit method from the storage. We don't need it anymore. Now let's review the storage. We receive an array of images, loop through them. For each image we check if it is a new one. Execute select query and return a promise. If the image doesn't exist in the database and the promise resolves, we store this image. Maybe this loop doesn't look very nice with these four levels of indentation, but I think here it is fine. In the connection string, we have provided idle equals zero. That means that once we are done with queries, the connection will be closed. From now we first scrape the required data about images. Then once everything is scraped, we save this data into the database.